Clear!
Anywhere.
flip here. That'll get us down. And I was watching my airspeed last time. I was down to about 40 miles an hour before the plane stopped flying. So I'm going to see if I can approach a little bit more slowly from now on to see if I can better control where I touch down. So we're aiming for the taxiway this time. Or closer. Other end of the runway. And look at that. Keeping it straight with the rudder, which is always a challenge. And there we go.
Mm-hmm.
buffeting at 35. And there's the break at 32. This one got a nose drop. Let's do that again. Let's bring it down. There's the buffeting at 35. And the nose drop at 32. Yep, that seems to be fairly consistent. I'm going to lower the nose. I'm going to bring the throttle up to about 4,000. And I'm going to see if I can just fly along at 40 miles an hour. That'd be too easy. Alright, let's see if I can maintain altitude at 40 miles an hour.
Drag, which means the nose goes in the wrong direction. Now it will come around eventually. You can fly
bank in the correct direction, and just with the rudder alone. And it stays very controllable. This is how the early ultralights flew, actually. They only had a rudder. They didn't use the ailerons. A quicksilver is a good example of that. A lot of dihedral in the wing, and then just a rudder to turn, and quite effective way of making a very simple airplane to fly. I need to lose some altitude. See how the plane flies. So engine off, still a nose down tendency. Descending at 700 feet a minute according to the airspeed indicator. So the way you would land this if you had lost your engine, it would be with lots of airspeed. So this is a sort of a best glide speed, 45 miles an hour. If I'm at 45 miles an hour and I want to stop at 400 feet, it's not 400, it's 3400. I don't really have the airspeed to do it. See, I did bring it to a stop, but right at the end there. You really want to keep lots of airspeed when you're coming into land, when you're gliding, because you want to have that extra energy to play around with your final altitude. So if I bring my airspeed up to 50, and say I want to stop at the 100 there, 10 feet up, I can start to flare. Still got the energy I need to let it touch down gently, and there's my stall pretty close to where my altitude was. I'm going to want to start this back up at around 2,500 feet, which we're coming on to, because I'm going to want to let the engine warm up before I give it any sort of power. That's something that happens when the engine's off and you're still flying through the air, because it's continuing to cool. And you don't want to shock cool it, and you don't want to cold seize it by turning it on too quickly and revving it up too quickly. So we're coming up to 2,500 feet. I'll go ahead and restart the engine. Clear! I guess I didn't need to say that. So you can see my water temperature is down below 140. So I'm going to keep my RPM at 4,000 or less until that water temperature comes back up above 140, because that's the temperature at which the thermostat opens. Once the thermostat opens and the water starts to circulate completely through the engine, it'll be safer to warm up the engine without worrying about cold seizing it. I'm going to want to fly a little bit slower. Less airflow over the radiators means more warmy-uppy. And we're holding altitude, so we're good at this RPM until the engine temperature comes back up. I'm going to go ahead and start making my approach back to the airport. We're going to fly overhead the field and join downwind for 3-1. I'll just continue to practice my slow flight as we get over there. Water temperature is starting to increase. We're at 135. I'm going to fly up over here towards the Trans-Canada, and then go down around through downtown Woodstock, and then join straight in on 3-1, or downwind for 3-1. There's my water temperature up above 140 now. Just going to keep an eye on it, wait to see if the needle drops. So I may have missed it. I haven't been keeping my eyes on it. See if the needle drops, letting me know that the thermostat's opened. There was a very slight decrease in the needle there. I'm not sure if that was a thermostat or just instrumentation error. I'll just keep an eye on it. I'll wait for it to get to 150 before I do anything crazy with the throttle. Bring the throttle up to 5,000. And there, the needle definitely dropped that time. And now it's continuing to climb again. So the thermostat's open, we're good. We'll just continue to let the engine warm up at this RPM. Not that we'll need 1500.
Watching. We'll catch you next time.